on here from Live Ocean Grown. We're at our beautiful headquarters here in Southern California. Today we are going to make our four-tier salad tower. I'll show you all the equipment that we're going to use right now. We're going to get started. Use a little sandpaper to clean up the edge. You know what's really cool about here at Live Ocean Grown? I already did everything and pre-drilled it. I'm just gonna show you how to do it because I know your time is valuable and so is mine. So now we're gonna start putting it together with the bamboo. Like I said before, we've already drilled all of our holes in all four of our tops where our plants are gonna go. Equal distances on all four sides. Now we're going to use our bamboo or stands, whatever you want to call them. So the first thing you're going to do is stand up your stand, bamboo or PVC, and you're going to mark, put the bamboo on the ground or on the table where you're working, and go through your hole in your bottom piece and mark a hole into your bottom of your bamboo. That's where you're going to drill your hole to secure your base, and then you're going to measure 12 inches from there, and you're going to drill holes 12 inches all the way up this piece of bamboo. Last thing you want to make sure, well, I guess before you started drilling the holes, is make sure that they're all in line. The next thing you're going to do is put the stand onto the base. So you're going to feed your wire tie or however you're going to secure your base. So you're going to put it through the bamboo, and then you're going to come back out the hole, go around the bamboo again, your wire tie. This is probably difficult. You might need help doing this, but I've done it enough times I could do it. Tighten your wire tie up, and that's going to secure. Don't tighten the wire tie up too much because otherwise you're going to squeeze it and it's going to go up like this, and you're never going to be able to get your planting material up above it. So just tighten it up a little bit. Now we're going to just go through and start tightening up our wire ties. You don't want to cinch them down to the point where you just want to cinch them up a little bit. Make sure that it's straight and your planting bases are level. All right, guys, our next process is to do our pump and our irrigation system. So we are going to drill a hole in the center of our cap, the same outside diameter of whatever tubing that we're going to use. The tubing that I'm going to use is 1/2 inch OD, 3 inch ID, outside diameter, inside diameter. So I have a 1/2 inch spade bit. I'm going to drill a hole right in the center of the cap where my tubing is going to go through. To show you that in a minute. The next thing I'm going to do is drill only two for right now holes along the outside rim of the cap, making sure that I don't mess around with the seal around the outside. I'm going to drill them at a little bit of an angle, and I'll tell you why in one sec. The reason why I'm drilling them at an angle is because I want the water to go out. And the reason why I'm only drilling two is because I want the areas of each planting area to have enough water that it fills up, but it doesn't overflow. Even if it did overflow, it wouldn't be that big of a nightmare because it would go down the shape of the top and go right back into where we want it to go. We just don't want it to somehow find its way to the zip tie, go down the bamboo. By the time we get home from work or play or wherever we're going, we're out of water, we got dead fish. We don't want to kill fish. All right, step 10 or 12, or I don't know what we're on here right now. Put your caps on all the way to the top. And we just drilled half inch and 1/8 inch holes in. We are going to, this is our pump. Our pump is going to sit in the bottom of our tank. So instead of feeding all of this, we're going to feed this tube through the half inch holes that we drilled all the way up. Just going to kind of measure out how much tubing I need so I don't have to feed 10 feet of tubing through something where I only needed, you know, 5 or 6 feet. Through the cap, I'm going to pull a lot through because I'm going to take each cap off as we go. You'll see why. We don't want to fight each cap and pull through, possibly rip the cap. All right, our next process is to get the pump down into our bottom tank area and to straighten out the tubing. So I'm going to pull the tubing up. I want to try to make sure that my pump stays, there's suction cups on the bottom of the pump. I want to try to make sure that those, basically that they're being used and my tubing is straight. Does it have to be? No. Does it look better? Absolutely. Once the plants grow around the tubing, you're never even going to know it's there.
This is going to be where the water pumps to the very top of your growing bed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, the tubing itself does a natural curl, so I'm going to make sure that the tubing stays to the outside of the top of my growing area, and it actually worked out perfect. You can leave a lot of extra on the top if you want, but we don't. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this piece of tubing, I'm going to crimp it, put a zip tie around it. You can use a cap if you want, but I prefer to use a 1 cent zip tie rather than a couple dollar cap. I'm gonna cut it. This part right here is absolutely critical. Put the tubing around the outside of the top growing bed, however, about a half inch from the top. You're gonna take a pin and you're going to go around and mark the bottom of the tubing with the Sharpie in a couple areas, because we're going to drill a hole in the bottom of it. Why do we want to drill a hole in the top of the tubing? Because we don't want to lose water. We don't want water to be spraying up instead of down into our growing medium. This part right here is definitely, you can pull the tubing back out and do it on a workbench if you want. Or you could do it here. Just be very careful not to drill through your fingers. And you don't have to do a whole lot. You can see I'm drilling into my mark. Only through the bottom of the tubing, not through the whole entire piece of tubing. And then just pick out your waste. You can drill probably, I'd say, 6 or 7 holes all the way around the tubing. Then we're going to, after our holes are drilled, we're going to take it and put it back the way that we marked the holes. So there we go, we're just gonna leave it for now. As long as the holes are down, we're kind of good to go. Now we're going to put water in it and actually see if it works.
Wet test run number one. Here's what we're doing now. If you notice, we only drilled 2 holes in each cap. What we don't want to happen is none of these to fill up and overflow. So right now we're going to let it run. And it looks like the top one's starting to fill up a lot faster than the other ones. So I'm going to actually turn the pump down on the side of the pump, which we'll show you when we put this thing all together. There's a flow switch on it, on the side of it, that you can minimize and maximize the amount of water that you want to flow in. All right, we've been running about 5 minutes now. I did have to drill a bunch of holes in various caps. We're pretty good to go now. One of the things that I want to mention, let me turn this off real quick, just a little tip, is just make sure that the holes that you drill on your cap are cleaned out. There could be waste, leftover plastic from drilling the holes in there that over time may come loose and then you end up flooding this one. So just be diligent about, everything's got to be clean and nice, and you're building this thing to make food and you're a quality amateur craftsman or a professional craftsman or whatever, but the biggest thing is just do it right. Clean up your plastic. All right, everything's been washed really good. And in this bucket I have reverse osmosis water, because now we're going to put this thing together, put fish and plants in it. So we need good water that has no chlorine or chemicals that are sitting, all the crap that they put in our water system. I also brought this out. If you don't have a reverse osmosis system, use bottled water. There's no chlorine in it. There's nothing that can harm the fish or the vegetables. Or you. Next step is, I'm going to use expanded clay pebbles, hydroton, or you can use some type of gravel or any type of gravel or small rock that you have laying around the house. Make sure it's washed. These expanded clay pebbles right here have been washed. They're in water right now. They've been washed. And clay pebbles also have a reddish dye color in there, which the fish ain't gonna like. So we're gonna fill up our spots. The next step is to put plants in there. Can you put soil plants, store-bought, inside of your four-tower salad or four-tier salad tower? Absolutely. We'll show you how in a minute. Or you can do this. Oh, we're going into the greenhouse. You can start them from here, which I showed you on the last video. You can use anything that you planted in seeds. Rock wool, some of our 2-inch neti pots ain't doing so good, or you could do this. Oh, is that that 250-gallon aquaponics tank? Yes, it is. But up top of the tank is our babies. So you can take, this right here is corn, which is going in one of our containers. We got some other stuff down there. I won't bore you with the details. Start your own seeds, grow your own food, or you can go buy soil products from your favorite landscaping yard or whatever and put them in your four-tier salad tower. Bought from your lovely Home Depot. It's certified organic, and they are, it doesn't even say, it's a home gardener tomato. Oh, there's a Better Boy, Early Girl, Beef Master, Cherry, Celebrity, and Roma. So I have 6 tomato plants in here. I always save the tags and put them where they go, because we're gonna plant these tomatoes in our top section, because these are going to get the biggest. And if you notice, I left the bamboo long because we're gonna actually create a trellis system on the top so that our tomatoes will be trellis. So basically we're gonna get the soil off this as much as possible. So, and there's water in here because I'm gonna soak. I'm basically just gonna hold the plant by its stalk here, get as much of the soil as I can off of it, you're not going to hurt the plant. As long as they've been watered and the roots are moist, you'll be fine. So that's about as much as I can get off. I'm going to soak it in the water, try to let it just sit there while I do another one. What kind of water do you have in there, Ron? It's reverse osmosis water. It is 70 degrees. Do plants like 70 degree water? Water, absolutely. What is the pH? pH is 7. So just gonna keep working these little guys until I get all the soil off of them and all I have is roots that are left. You know, if there's a little bit of soil left on there, I mean, you don't have to go crazy, you know, getting every single little bit off of it. The biggest thing is get a majority of it. You're gonna change the water in 7 days anyway. So all you're gonna do is push the clay pebbles to the side. I'm gonna plant the tomato plants by the legs because, like I said, we're gonna create a trellis system and it's just easier. I don't wanna have to mess around with a bunch of wire or something that's, which we might need because we're gonna grow like 10 pounds of tomatoes up here, aren't we? And just keep on planting them up. Clay pebbles on the top of it. Just kind of move the hose to the side. The hose needs to make, sure that the hose is down, not over the top. Basically, we're just covering the roots of the tomato plants with clay pebbles. And we're making sure that our top hose is anywhere between a half inch to three quarters down from the rim of the top grow container. We're just gonna keep planting all of our stuff down to the bottom. See you next time. LiveOceanGrowing.com. Everything's planted, ready to go. We got our herbs down here. We got cilantro and a couple different types of oregano. We got our spinach here. We got our collard greens and our tomatoes. And if you notice, we chopped the other tomatoes because I found aphids on the tomatoes and I don't mess around with bugs at all. So anytime I see any bugs on plants, we basically just usually toss them unless we can organically get rid of the bugs. And from my experience, you normally can't. You can see in the bottom, let's review one more time, there's a pump in the bottom of the bottom container, which now has a couple goldfish in it. It pumps all the way up through the top into a hose up here that has a couple holes drilled in it. Each one drains into the other one and then finally drains down into the bottom where the fish actually get aeration because of the way that the water falls into the bottom of the tank. Hopefully with the nutrition that the fish waves gives the plants and the plants will clean the water, we'll have a cool little four-tier salad tower where we can come out and pick our own salad. Grow your own food, theoceangrown.com.